Ucypher, India's first multi-gaming, multi-platform esports championship. 6 teams of 14 players each compete across 4 games. Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. Each team faces the other team twice in the league stage. And 3 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Tekken 7 and Real Cricket 17 in each match. 5 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Dota 2 and CSGO games in a match. The top 4 teams in the league stage move to the knockout rounds. U Cypher, 6 teams, 84 cyber athletes, and a grand prize pool of 51 lakh rupees.
Gentlemen, it's gaming time. My name is Aisha and this is India's only multi-platform, multi-gaming, multiplayer esports championship, U Cypher. Being a gamer is not easy. Kyunki just to explain to someone that I'm not wasting time but instead developing and practicing my skills as a pro gamer is a task in itself. So I salute the patience in every gamer here.
And as we see, the competition is getting cutthroat at every step. Ask our game is between the Yakshas and the Akramaks, and both the teams are ready to battle it out and show their dominance. So without wasting any more time, let the battle begin.
Guys, welcome to day 7 of the championship. Any initial thoughts?
हमेशा जैसे खेलते आ रहे हैं जो ऐसी होगा और जॉन्टी का एज ऑलवेज पहले टेकन होने वाला है अभी तक उसने दोनों को 3-0 हराया है तो मैं आज होप कर रहा हूं कि आज भी ये 3-0 ही हराएगा और हमको अच्छा स्टार्ट देगा
Oh, so looking forward to a new, like a good start. How are you feeling?
काफी एक्साइटेड हूं आई एम हियर टू ड्रॉ द फर्स्ट ब्लड लाइक आई ऑलवेज डू
बहुत टेंशन है पिछला गेम बहुत बुरी तरह से हार चुके थे चारों गेम में हारे थे 16 पॉइंट्स का लीड दे दिया हम लोग ने मार्क्समैन को इस गेम में नई शुरुआत है नया दिन है तो अच्छे से खेलना है फोकस
Do you think the Akramaks have learned from their mistakes? Have you seen their game? Have you studied what they are good at?
We have studied their game and we are not going to underestimate anybody. This time we are not keeping any room for error.
All right, Yakshas.
Akramaks are known as a complete team. क्या हुआ last game? I would want to know that.
प्रॉब्लम ऐसे हो गई थी कि हम लोग में एक सॉर्ट ऑफ ओवर कॉन्फिडेंस बहुत बढ़ गया था कि हमें कोई हरा नहीं पाएगा तो हम लोग जो वाइट वॉश हुए जो चारों गेम हारे वो मुझे लगता है कि वो बहुत अच्छा हुआ क्योंकि इसके बाद ये स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द टूर्नामेंट ही हो गया तो वो बेटर था सो आज हम लोग बेसिकली बहुत पम्प्ड अप है होपफुली हम लोग यहाँ पे मिनिमम 10 पॉइंट्स तो लेके ही जाएंगे
ऑलराइट द आक्रमक्स आर रेडी गाइस लेट्स गो आक्रमक्स
अक्षय
आक्रमक्स
अक्षय
हेलो एवरीवन वेलकम टू द मैच डे 7 एट यू साइफर आज का मैच है आक्रमक्स और यक्षास के बीच में टॉन्टी टैंक एंड आई बॉट हैव परफॉर्म्ड रियली वेल एंड ऑलवेज गिवन देम अ गुड स्टार्ट आई थिंक यक्षास विल बी द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट टीम इन यू साइफर देन
एग्जैक्टली अमर लाइक यू सेड द यक्षास आर इन फॉर्म दे आर ऑन 17 पॉइंट्स व्हिच मींस दे आर थर्ड ऑन द लीडर बोर्ड दे आर कैचिंग अप टू द मार्क्समैन एंड टुडेज गेम्स आर गोना बी सुपर इंपॉर्टेंट ऑन द अदर हैंड वी हैव द आक्रमक्स हु आर इन डिसमल फॉर्म दे हैव लॉस्ट द लास्ट 4 गेम्स नो पॉइंट्स And they are reeling at the bottom, at the 5th position on our leaderboard. And seriously, if they want to be anywhere close to the top 3 or top 4 to qualify, they need to get points today.
I think they can still do it.
I'm really excited to see if the Akramaks can come up. Yakshas, you have to watch out for the Akramaks. Don't rule them out.
It's day 7 of our championship and we're going to begin with an epic game of Tekken 7 by Bandai Namco on the Sony PS4 platform. Before we go straight into the game, let's have a look at the rules. प्लेयर्स अपने कैरेक्टर सिलेक्ट करेंगे हर राउंड में जिसका एचपी खत्म हो जाएगा वो राउंड हार जाएगा हर मैच एक रेस है 3 राउंड्स जीतने की और जो प्लेयर पहले 3 मैचेस जीतेगा वो बनेगा टेकन 7 का विनर लेट द बैटल बिगिन
आफ्रो निंजा आपका जो पूरा टीम था They lost all 4 games. So any preparation going into the game?
Captain मेरे को बोल रहा था अरे क्या है Jaunty tank कौन सी tank है तेरे पास तो भाई B2 bomber लेके बैठा है तू बोला ठीक है भाई आज तो bomb गिरा दूँगा.
तो आज आपके fighter में कोई change आया?
हाँ आज मैं Kazumi से खेलूँगा.
Kazumi से खेलोगे? क्यों?
क्योंकि new character है Tekken 7 में introduce हुई है और उसका एक pet है share. तो शेर अपने जलवे दिखा देगा.
Nice. One last message for Jaunty Tank.
Good luck, bro.
Akramaks! Akshay!
Jaunty, you're repping team Yakshas for the first game of the day. You are unbeaten so far. Is this a lot of pressure?
There is always a pressure, but I always believe that I take that pressure. So, मुझे अच्छा लगता है situation, so I draw the first blood.
Afro Ninja को क्या बोलना चाहेंगे?
I would just like to tell him कि भाई game पे ध्यान दो, move से नहीं खेलते, हाथ से खेलते.
Yes, nice.
Let's get ready for an epic game of Tekken 7. This is going to be interesting.
Kazumi Mishima, Katarina Elvis.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is me, Jirin, with you guys. It's gonna be Yakshas versus the Akramaks.
Round one. Fight.
Well, you have seen Jaunty playing with Katarina and Afro Ninja with Kazumi. And now it's the game, the round one begins, and at the start only it's a lot of pressure built up on Kazumi right there because she is low on HP, and that's a knockout coming in. Well, the first round goes to the Yakshas over here. Well, it's gonna be round two, like perfect block coming in for Katarina over there, but not for long as the Tiger Bounce comes in, giving him some lot of damage that he won't be able to deal with it now. But he is also putting some nice pressure with coming back with a nice reply on Kazumi, but Kazumi is well prepared for this fight, and that is gonna be a knockout with the Tiger Bounce coming in. What a game. Well, Afro Ninja is showing us some nice skills today. Well, it's one all the score for both of them, and Katarina now taking some damage. Well, perfect blocks coming in from the players as well, maintaining that distance between these two players, but Tiger Bounce maintaining that distance from Katarina. Well, it's another knockout coming in as gonna be Kazumi who's gonna win the second one as well.
Fight.
Well, Kazumi is using the Tiger Bounce really good to maintain that distance between Katarina because Katarina has those long legs and that she can just easy sweep Kazumi. So it's not a good strategy to play aggressive with Kazumi over there. But if Katarina thinks to go in, well, like looks like that it's gonna happen. And yes, it does. Well, he thought of going in with the nice aggression from Jaunty Tank, and he got that round. And this is gonna be the fifth round. Well, whoever wins this is gonna be their round. Now not looking good for Kazumi, and she does have the rage out to work with, but no, it's gonna be a knockout coming in for her, and it's gonna be the Yakshas for the three sweet points for them.
Round one.
Well, it's gonna be match number two. Fight. Katarina now have read the game of Kazumi, how she is playing, but still maintaining that distance with the Tiger Pounce coming in. Well, she does have the rage out to work with, and the Tiger comes in between just to save Kazumi over there. She is low on HP. Just a single tap and a hit would just knock her out. Both of them have the rage out, but rage out comes in from Kazumi, and well, she does win the first round of the second match. Now we are going into round number two. It's not looking good for Kazumi as she is taking some damage, and Katarina still on like full HP, but now comes back with a reply. Kazumi playing good. Well, now Katarina not giving you a single chance, and that's a smash to the ground. Kazumi is now under a lot of pressure, and that's a knockout coming in. What in the hell is going wrong with Kazumi right now? She was playing amazing game earlier, and now it's not looking good for her. Looks like she has lost a little bit of confidence, but it won't be for long. Well, she can show us nice comeback into the game, and there she pulls up rage out, but no, it's gonna be Katarina. Just a tap to the head, and she goes down. That's a knockout. Round number three begins with a huge damage coming on Kazumi. Well, she has gone low on HP, just like a 50% HP down, going for more. She does have the rage out to work with, but Kazumi is really low on HP. Katarina not giving a single chance, beating her to death. This is not looking good as round number two also goes to the Yakshas.
Round one.
So this is gonna be the last round. If they win this, they are gonna take the 3 points in their pockets. And looks like this is gonna go for the Yakshas because Katarina is not gonna go down easy because he is putting up some lot of pressure. Well, just a little bit of HP left, just a single hit, and she would be off for a knockout. A perfect block coming in, and that's a knockout. What a perfect block coming in from Katarina. Amazing gameplay Round number two begins with a huge damage on Kazumi. Looks like she is not able to handle that pressure. The perfect strings connecting from the Katrina in the previous round was amazing. This is round number three. If Katrina wins this, it's going to be easy points for them. It's not going to be Kazumi who's going to make it easy for Katrina as well, as she is putting up some pressure and maintaining that distance as well at the same time. Now it's going to be Katrina who's going to show who's the boss in this game, and she is now putting the pressure. Well, that wasn't a perfect game for the Akramaks.
Yakshas, you have drawn first blood and you have earned yourself 3 points, guys. Congratulations. Yeah. Unbeaten still. And Jaunty, what a quick learner. You won 3-2, then 3-1, and in the end, the last round was 3-0.
Yeah.
You finally learned how to sidestep that tiger, right? How did that happen?
Initially, he played really well and he was countering my moves and he was punishing me with the 1-2 punches. But eventually, I just played my strength. I was confusing him upar niche, and that really helped me out on that.
It's so much fun to watch you. Congratulations, Yakshas are at 3 points.
After that epic game of Tekken 7, we move on to our next game on U Cypher Naya Sport Naya Superstars, which is Real Cricket 17 by Nautilus Mobile.
ये एक बैटिंग ओनली मैच है। हर प्लेयर एक ओवर फेस करेगा जिसमें उसे मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने होंगे। मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने वाला प्लेयर मैच जीत जाएगा। टाई होने पर दोनों प्लेयर्स एक सुपर ओवर खेलेंगे टू डिसाइड द विनर।
I'm here with both the captains who are all set for the toss. Akramaks, aapke last match mein you lost all 4 games and aaj subah you lost Tekken. How important is the toss for you?
Bahut important hai next game mein lead lene ke liye, equal hone ke liye points. Aur last game hara tha to har din nayi shuruaat rehti hai. To aaj nayi shuruaat hai.
And Yakshas, what a start to the day. Jaunty Tank ne aapka jo level hai, jo morale ka level hai, wo yahan set kar raha hai.
Hamesha kar.
How important is cricket for you?
क्रिकेट इज़ ऑलवेज इम्पॉर्टेंट. हम लोग अभी तक एक भी मैच नहीं हारे क्रिकेट में और टेकन में सिंगल प्लेयर गेम्स में, और हाईएस्ट स्कोर भी हमारे प्लेयर ने बनाया हुआ है, तो आज भी मैं काफ़ी कॉन्फिडेंट हूँ कि वो खेल पाएगा, अच्छे से परफॉर्म कर पाएगा.
ऑलराइट, इट्स टाइम फॉर द टॉस. हू इज़ कॉलिंग?
कप्पा.
हेड्स.
हेड्स इट इज़.
वी विल प्रेफर टू चेस.
ऑल द बेस्ट कप्पा.
थैंक यू.
ऑल द बेस्ट कैप्टन.
गुड.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the U Cypher League, and this is Real Cricket 17. It's gonna be Yakshas versus the Akramaks today. Ibot versus Love SX. So Ibot is gonna bat first now, and let's see how this game goes. It's the first ball, and he has hit a nice six. Well, 6 runs scored on the first ball of the game. So now it's the second ball. Still 5 more balls to go. Second ball comes in, and that's an LBW. He is out. So one wicket down for the Yakshas. Not looking good for them, and Akramaks pretty much happy with that wicket. Still 3 more balls to go, and he has again hit a ball for a 6. This guy is playing pretty much insane, and he is playing good cricket. 3 balls still left, and now that's a nice hit coming in from Ibot, but still the ball goes for a 4, so not bad. Still scores 4 runs in that ball. 4th ball coming in, and that's a huge hit coming in, and that's a 6. So now the last ball remaining for the Yakshas. Will it be a 4 or a 6? And looks like it's going out of the boundaries again, but it's a little bit less, so it's still a 4 coming in for them. So 26 runs, not bad. So that means Akramaks needs 27 runs in 6 ball to win the game. So now it's chance for Love SX to show us his skills in Real Cricket 2017. Well, the first ball comes in for him, and that is gonna be a dot ball for him. He is looking a little bit sad. So
He needs a good ball over here just to hit. Like, oh, nice shot coming in from him. And that is not going to go for a four. But let's see how many runs can he take over here. It's just going to be two runs for Love SX. Third ball coming in for Love SX. And that's really a nice shot from his side. It's going for a six. So three balls left now. He needs all three balls sixes. Otherwise, the Akramaks are out right now. And he has hit the shot and is going for a six, but no, just an inch away, and it's a four. So they are definitely losing this game, and your winners are the Yakshas.
The winner of Real Cricket 17 is iBot with 26 runs. What were you thinking when you were batting first? Were you scared?
नर्वस बहुत था मैं कि सेकंड बॉल विकेट अभी क्या करना है कम से कम 26-28 रन चाहिए मैक्सिमम तो मैं वो हिसाब से खेला था और वो हुआ
परफेक्ट अब अगली गेम्स में क्या होगा वी आर गोना फाइंड आउट रियली सून 6 पॉइंट्स अप द यक्षास आर इन द लीड
लेट्स गो यक्षास
वी आर अबाउट टू एंटर द मल्टीप्लेयर 5 पॉइंट गेम्स एंड द फर्स्ट वन इज द मोस्ट वाइडली प्लेड गेम एंड द मोस्ट लव्ड गेम इन द एंटायर वर्ल्ड I'm talking about CSGO by Valve Corporation.
इस गेम में दो टीम्स होती हैं, एक टेररिस्ट टीम और दूसरी काउंटर टेररिस्ट टीम। ये एक टीम बेस्ड गेम है जो 5 वर्सेस 5 के फॉर्मेट में खेला जाएगा। प्लेयर्स कौन सा मैप खेलेंगे, ये एक बैनिंग प्रोसेस से तय होगा। शुरुआत में दोनों टीम्स को $800 की गेम करेंसी मिलती है। The aim of the terrorist team is to plant the bomb and secure it or kill all the counter-terrorists. The aim of the counter-terrorist team is to either defuse the bomb or kill all the terrorists. इस मैच में 30 rounds होंगे and the first team to win 16 rounds is the game winner. In the case of a tie, the result will be decided with a race to 4 wins.
Guys, दो बार पास्ट में ऐसा हो चुका है जॉन्टी शुभम फर्स्ट मैचेस जीतते हैं उसके बाद हम लोग सीएस हार रहे हैं क्या गलत हो रहा है हमारे साथ
लास्ट मैच में अपन 4 गेम्स हारे हैं तो वही हार कंटिन्यू है पहले 2 गेम्स तो हार चुके हैं तो अभी कमबैक करने के लिए ये गेम जितना बहुत जरूरी है ये अगर जीते तो डोटा वाले अपना काम कर देंगे तो बेसिकली कल जो मिस्टेक्स किए अपन ने वो आज रिपीट नहीं करना है
हमेशा से अभी एग्रेसिव खेलने को ट्राई किया है हम लोग ने तो लेट्स ट्राई अ डिफेंसिव साइड दिस टाइम
वो लोग को तो पता है कपीश वैसे ही कॉल किया रहेगा कि बैठे रहो टी साइड से वे लोग आएंगे पुश करके मारेंगे वो हिसाब से खेलेंगे और कुछ आता नहीं है और वो शांतपत्ति तो करेगा डेड है वो बंदा तो उसको दिखाते हैं क्या कौन क्या है गेम में
आज का मैप है ना वो हिसाब से खेलते हैं वो टाइम पे जो बंदा मुंह खोल के बोल देगा ये करना है वही करते
Kappa, your previous CSGO game didn't go as planned. You said your strategy was on point, but your players did not manage to execute that well. Have you worked on that since then?
हाँ किया है उसके बाद हम लोग ने practice भी किया, decide भी किया. अभी देखते हैं execute कैसे करते हैं.
Akrid, have you studied their game?
Yes, we saw their games. We know how they play and उनकी strategy हमको पता है क्योंकि Kappa का जो ex teammate Impel है, वो Yakshas के लिए खेल रहा है. तो उसे बहुत कुछ पता है कि Kappa कैसे खेलता है और Manan Mithil भी, तो वो हमारे एक favour में जा सकता है.
Are you scared about this?
नहीं.
Game
तो game है. अपने अपने जगह पे हर कोई है.
Kappa, you are a legend in the Counter Strike Global Offensive community, right? What does this game mean to you?
Home ground.
This is very unpredictable. Good luck, guys.
Thank you.
Yakshas and Akramaks, may the best team win.
This is the map we do, and now let's see what do they choose. And it's gonna be Mirage. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Today it's gonna be the Akramaks versus the Yakshas. This is me, Jireen, and let's go directly into the knife fight between these teams. And currently they are like making like a distance between these two. Like they do not want to engage the fight early on the stage, but now it lets the slaughter begin. And now it's not looking good for the Yakshas because one by one the players are going down.
जब भी वो लोग अलग होके एक प्लेयर के ऊपर दो लोग आके टैग टीम करके मारने को आया नाइफ
टीम किल कमिंग इन एज इंपेल इज गोना स्टैब हिज ओन प्लेयर इट्स गोना बी स्कडूश
मेरे प्लेयर ने प्रॉपरली उसको
वो लोग दोनों को खींच लिया मैं पीछे से, क्या एक को स्टैप किया, फिर वो लोग दोनों मेरे को मारने को आए, तभी वो लोग का टीके हो गया।
मैंने 5 बार सॉरी भी बोला, इंटेंशनल नहीं था।
तभी तो हम लोग हंस रहे थे।
Still a win-win situation, and Badman giving a nice headshot to Recoil Master over there, and Manan taking those easy frags, but a refrag coming in from Mantri, making it a 3v3 situation. The bomb has gone down by Impale, and SMX coming in, and what a shot by SMX, a one bullet tap, and Kappa is going for the ninja defuse in the smokes. Kadush only left over here, but SMX is gonna shut him down. An amazing round coming in. This is round number 3. What a game in the previous round. So it's Kappa who's going for an aggressive push towards the underpass, and yes, he gets a frag on Impale. Well, Batman also shutting down Skadoosh over the ramps.
Setup हम लोग का वही था कि default position पे खेलो, एक window, दो A side, दो B shot, एक B shot और एक B house. तो हम लोग को पता था कि वो लोग fast आने के लिए देखेंगे, और उसके हिसाब से setup था, तो हम लोग prepare थे, वो लोग क्या करेंगे, कुछ नहीं करेंगे. हम लोग ने क्रॉस वायर में वो लोग को दो दो को मार दिया, और एक ने प्लांट किया था तो हम लोग ने डिफ्यूज कर दिया. इतना इजी था राउंड.
ये भाई थे.
Looks like Skadoosh has already made an entry, and what a shot coming in from Skadoosh.
वो लोग ने पहले से ही वहाँ पे साउंड कर दिया था, और मैंने तभी मॉली किया, तो वहाँ पे ऑलरेडी वो लोग अटके हुए थे. जब भी वो लोग आए तो मैं ऑलरेडी एम लेके खड़ा ही था वहाँ पे, तो बहुत ईजी हो गया फिर अगेन मारने का.
Not looking good for the Yakshas. They need to come up with some strategy because it's not working for them. And SMX with a nice boost on towards the side and nice angle. He gets down one player, but the players are aggressive on the Yakshas side. They are moving into the side. They get one frag. That's going to be SMX making the 4v4 situation. Skadoosh low on HP with the AWP. And yes, he goes down by Mithil. Mithil is just acting like a beast for the Yakshas. Currently, the C4 is going to go down, and Kappa is already on the side. He's going to take a fight against Impale, and Impale is going to shut him down, making it a 3v1 situation. And Mithil is going to shut down the last guy, who is going to be the star boy. He goes down as well, and the bomb has been defused. So 4-0, a clean wipe coming in for the Akramaks. Skadoosh moving towards ramp, and yes, he gets a headshot on Badman, and Recoil Master waiting over there for a push coming in from Mithil, and yes, he picks him up. A nice two-man lead over the Yakshas. So a nice setup as well. Kappa is pushing towards the underpass, and yes, he gets one frag. So making it a 3v4 situation.
वहाँ पे Recoil Master ने शायद से पहला pick लिया था. Man down हो गया, man advantage हमारे को आ गया. हमने खाली एक दूसरे को बोला कि अभी साथ में ही चले जाते हैं यार, और कुछ हो रहा नहीं है. सबने individual try कर लिए, और हम लोग फिर भी split होके ही गए, और basically कैसे तो भी मार के round जीत गए.
So 5-1 the scoreline currently.
Kapish T-ramp से निकला, उसने एक को मारा और वो वापस नहीं गया, वो मेरे से भी फाइट लेने लगा. तो वो टाइम मैंने बाहर निकल के उसको वन बुलेट मारा. थोड़े 2-3 सेकंड बाद कारपेट वाला बंदा आया, उसको भी मैंने सेम वो ही वन टैप मारा.
Kappa is just tag teaming up him as well. It's Starboy and triple taps. What is this by Manan? He gets down 3 easy one taps.
वो लोग direct ऊपर से B palace के ऊपर से flash करके घुसने try कर रहे थे. तो मैं direct van पे गया, ऊपर चढ़ के मैंने direct spray ही खोल दिया मेरा. तो वो ऐसा लग रहा था कि वो लोग मतलब ऐसे ही सिर्फ aim पे आने try कर रहे थे.
Manan pushing towards mid, and it's going to be Mantri alone left in this situation, the lone wolf for the team, a 1v4 situation, but he goes down as well. SMX shuts him down by giving him a nice headshot. 8-2 the current scoreline, and that push coming in from Skadoosh was a mistake, and he goes down by paying on his life. So 3v5 situation right now.
मैंने actually decide किया कि हम लोग उस default पे नहीं खेलेंगे, और दो execute हम लोग ने fast decide किए थे. वो हम लोगों ने ट्राई करने की कोशिश की, पर उसमें हम लोगों ने स्मोक्स फेल कर दिए, और हमारे प्लेयर्स यहाँ वहाँ पसर के ही मर गए.
It's gonna be like a passive play coming in from them right now, because the C4 couldn't go down. It was on side but couldn't go down, and SMX comes in with a nice frag over Starboy, ending this round. Well, Akramaks with a huge lead over the Yakshas, an 8-round lead. SMX with a nice angle shuts down Skadoosh over there, making it a one-man advantage for the Akramaks. And Manandar is just raining bullets over Yakshas, gets two instant frags.
Ulog aaye andhe jaisa, ghuse jungle ke andar. So, hum log ka crossfire tha, Manan ne dusri side se mara. So, jo players meri taraf bhag ke aa rahe the, wo Manan ko dekhna chalu kar diya aur maine mufti mara.
And still maintaining that lead. That lead is huge on them. And Manan just stepping in with that frag, easy, making it look so easy. Manan and Mithil, the wombo combo boys, like just two instant frags over them. The smoke pops in, a mistake, but that still creates a wall and a defensive wall for Manan as well as he is inside the smoke. Starboy does manage to pull it out. Badman, they don't know that the player is waiting in the smoke. And a nice reflex coming in, and Manan goes down. But Mithil coming in with a nice backup.
1v1 situation aya mera aur recoil master ka. Wo side ke piche tha. Mere paas op thi aur P250 tha mera haath mein. To usne wall bang karke flash kiya. Maine wo avoid kare easily aur close range jaake maar diya.
He's gonna win this fight for his team. He's going for the C4 defuse. Well, he has a lot of time to work on it. And yes, the C4 has been defused. So 12-2, the current scoreline, not looking good for the Yakshas. They at least like need like approximately like 6 rounds in the first half to win, but not looking good right now. SMX is going for the first frag, and Badman going for the second, and Manan is going for the third frag. It's just raining frags on the server right now, making it a 4v2 situation. Mantri and Impale left. They have to pull out this round. It would be a magic trick if they pull it off.
If you're playing Mirage, that is the first thing you will ever learn as a strategy in Mirage. A, smokes. And these guys did a blunder out of those smokes as well. CT ke smoke mein bhi gap tha. Sab log yahan wahan pasar ke mar gaye.
Well, the second half begins. 13-2 the scoreline, a huge advantage towards the Akramaks side. Some bullets had been taken by Badman, like a little bit of damage, but that won't do a lot as he does manage to shut down Starboy and Recoil Master as well. SMX coming in with the third frag. Badman pulling down the C4 over there, and Manan is just taking some damage coming in from the outer side. But Mithil is gonna shut Impale down. And Mantri as well with a nice headshot, making it easy win for the Akramaks. 15-2 the current scoreline. Mithil going in with those frags, two headshots already. Well, Impale is going for the backstab on Kappa, and Kappa has no info. There's a player coming in from behind, and it's gonna be Impale who's gonna shut him down, and Mantri is gonna shut down Mithil. So the C4 is going down right now, and it's gonna be 15-2. If the Akramaks wins this, it's gonna be easy 5 points for them. And Mantri goes down, making it a 1v2 situation for Impale. And he goes down as well by SMX. And Akramaks have won this 16-2. A huge lead, a huge score. This is like an impossible score to set against the Akramaks. This is me, Jareen, signing off.
What a performance by Akramaks out here. Yeah. They completely destroyed Yakshas in Counter-Strike. This was needed by them, and they've done it.
Right.
They're back in the face-off today.
Yes.
They've got the 5 points that were needed.
Right. The Akramaks won the most important knife round, decided to play counter-terrorist, and won back the pistol round.
In Counter-Strike, it's all about a team play.
Right.
Today, Akramaks showed how you play as a team in Counter-Strike.
Right. And now, the Akramaks have their 5 points, which means it all boils down to the last game, which is Dota 2.
So let's watch Dota 2 now, if Akramaks can upset Yakshas out there and take the 5 points and win today's face-off.
After the end of Game 3, the Akramaks have made a fantastic comeback. Congratulations, Kappa. But before talking to you, Yakshas, what's happening, man? Aap abhi tak ek bhi game CS karne jeete. This continues, you lose out 5 points every time.
Pata nahi abhi kya ho raha hai, kyunki practice ke liye bhi aaye the LAN pe, practice bhi hui thi, par stage pe jaake kya ho raha hai, kya galtiyan ho rahi, kuch samajh nahi raha, pauses nahi liye ja rahe.
Bas 16-2 is a bad score to lose.
It's really bad, exactly. Aaj, today's performance was really disappointing.
Better luck next time. But Kappa, what a comeback, man. What do you want to say?
Zaruri tha. Aur wo log ka CSGO ka team kafi weak hai. Wo log sab log se haar chuke, to hum log ke liye utna tough competition nahi tha. Aage dekhte kya hota hai.
Well, all the best. All the best, Captain. Great victory.
The Akramaks have 5 points now, and the Yakshas stand at 6.
In this power-packed game, our players use this time to get fully charged and pumped for the next game, which is Dota 2 by Valve Corporations.
Dota 2 में हर प्लेयर अपने लिए एक हीरो सिलेक्ट करेंगे। इस गेम में दो टीम्स कंपीट करेंगी इन अ 5 वर्सेस 5 फॉर्मेट। हर हीरो के पास स्पेशल पावर्स और एबिलिटीज होती हैं। हर टीम का ऑब्जेक्टिव है अपने एंशिएंट्स को डिफेंड करना और अपने ओपोनेंट के सारे टावर्स को डिस्ट्रॉय कर देना। जो टीम पहले एनिमी टीम के डिफेंस को तोड़कर उनके सारे टावर्स डिस्ट्रॉय कर देगी, वो टीम जीतेगी।
Akramaks are back in the game. You guys are at 5 points. How important is this game for you?
बहुत जरूरी है ये गेम में लीड करने के लिए। कल का मैच हारने के बाद हम लोग ने बहुत कुछ डिस्कस किया है। उसके बाद बहुत सारे चेंजेस लाए। बेसिकली कल किको बेंच पे था, आज वो खेलेगा
okay.
और वो लीड करेगा।
ओके
okay. और ग्रेप सोडा बेंच होएगा।
Who's your in-game leader?
आज किको।
किको। Acrid, does this lineup change things for your strategy?
Nothing. We just gonna play our game.
These guys haven't won Dota yet.
आज भी नहीं।
Wow, that's a challenge.
Challenge accepted. देखते क्या होता है।
देखते हाँ।
All the best, loving the confidence, Akrid. Good luck, Kappa.
Confidence, bhai.
The game that always gets my heart racing, Dota 2 between the Akramaks and the Yakshas.
Gentlemen, welcome back to U Cypher, Naya Sport, Naya Superstars. My name is Vivek, with me is CloudX, and you're watching the Yakshas on the Radiant facing off versus the Akramaks on the Dire.
On the bottom lane, it's Akrid farming up on the Juggernaut while Dream is up against him. Max is going to be supporting him on that Lich and Freak. Freak on the Jukiro getting caught in the trees. You don't want to be duking with the Monkey King in the trees. That's 4 stacks of Jingo Mastery.
मैं थोड़ा सा डिस्ट्रैक्टेड था, तभी फिर आउट ऑफ पोजीशन था, फिर रूबिक ने लिफ्ट किया और स्पिन में उधर मर गया।
Stream is about to go down. He ends up giving first blood.
Mid lane, it seems we have a charge coming out onto VP. Appa's in the vicinity, charge onto the Rubik. Can Appa turn this around? With the gold stamp, they might look for the kill, but look at that, the familiars! Along with the soul assumption, VP ends up falling, and it's a free kill for the Dire Freak though. Needs to be careful, the familiar is still pounding away.
Looks like it's 11 minutes in now, 3-1 in favor of Akramaks.
Spin chalu kiya, meri team ne backup diya. Rubik ne lift kiya, to utne mein spin mein monkey mar gaya. जैसे मंकी मारा मेरे पास मेरा अल्टीमेट जो ओमनी स्लैश होता है वो रेडी था मैंने सीधा वो लीच पे कास्ट कर दिया जो इंस्टेंट डेथ हो गई उसकी वहाँ पे
वार्ड के विजन से अर्चेकर दिख रहा था वहाँ पे ब्लू फ्रॉग ने मुझे कॉल दिया कि अपन इसको मार सकते हैं तू टॉप से एरो डाल और मैं यहाँ से चार्ज करता हूँ तो अपन उसको किल कम्प्लीट कर सकते हैं क्योंकि हमारे दोनों के पास विजन है
VP is here, he's TP to a shrine, but there's not much he can do. Freak with the dual breath, the moonlight shadow. Both teams just poking and prodding, looking for an opening, but it seems they're gonna disengage.
Now 4-3 in favor of the Akramaks. They're gonna go on the invoke over the ice path to keep the spirit breaker away, but it doesn't matter because Kiko slams him to the ground with the soul assumption. A long range dagger strike, a bash for good measure. Freak is getting pincer trapped and gets brought down. Akramaks charging forward again. Bottom lane, 13 minutes in. They're gonna go in with Blue Frog leading the way. There's the ice path, a good game. Fury and Omni Slash as well. It's Blue Frog about to go down and he gets sliced to bits by Akrid. Yakshas are turning it around, but Kiko says no. Comes in and gets a return kill.
Yakshas, smoke maneuver coming out here. The ice path misses Dream and Akramaks might just end up escaping, but the lift is there. The Sunstrike to follow. Actually, a little bit of a misplay coming out from VP.
Roshan about to go down. You're really low on HP. Akramaks trying to secure the lead here, but Invoker is coming in from behind. Appa is prepped and ready to make a play. Now they're trying to fight with the Spirit Breaker already dead. They're also going to end up giving up the Aegis.
थोड़ा miscoordination हो गया उन लोग का.
और वो गेम भी हार गए और रोशन में एजिस भी वेस्ट हो गया मेरा.
They look to capitalize on this. Yakshas just moving through the mid lane. Kalank's got to be careful. Chain Frost bouncing through the Primal Spring is there. They're focusing the Earthshaker, the Enchanted, and buys in time. But Max with the last hit gets the kill for the Akramaks. Well, make believe scores another.
In the jungle, Peek now on that Jakiro, throws down the dual, gets the macro fire, but ends up going down. Kiko gets the double, Dream gets a single, and it's Akramaks getting a bunch of kills there in the jungle.
तो चार हीरोज थे इन्वोकर का जैसे उसने अपना टॉर्नेडो यूज़ किया साइक्लोन जैसा और उसके साथ उन लोग का जगरनॉट भी था जो इनिशिएट वो आगे आया उसने अपना स्पिन विन यूज़ किया और अच्छे करता जिसने एकोस्लैम वगैरह पावर्स यूज़ किए और उसमें हमारी टीम थोड़ा बैकफुट पे आ गई. उसके बाद हम लोग ने अपने स्पेल्स यूज़ करके दो तीन हीरो को मार दिया और मैं जो कैरी कर रहा था मेरा ना उसे टावर पुश किया और वैसे रैक्स ले लिया.
Guess that Roshan was okay. Blue Frog, hold on, what are you doing? I mean, this was all a trap all along. VP is in no man's land and with the solo assumption, he's gonna end up going down.
That's four down on the side of Yakshas. They lose their first lane of barracks on the bottom side of the map and Akramaks are one step closer to taking the win here. Is there as well. Make believe just Mantas and leaps out of it. Akrid is left spinning to win there, but doesn't get much done. Appa, meanwhile, ends up dropping. Dream puts him to bed. While the base has now been breached, two buybacks come out from the Yakshas. Dream is atop the treetops, jumps in behind enemy lines, goes to work on BP with those Jinju stacks, and gets himself a double kill before making his way out. But now he's lifted. He's overstayed as well.
Yeah, too many costly deaths here, but Dream is going to end up going down. And this might be enough for the Yakshas to hold on to high ground. In fact, they're going to chase. They've caught Make Believe on the Mirana. Akramaks, they do not want to be giving up too many frags on the retreat. Mirana controlled by the Fisher, the Enchanted and follow. Have they caught the detection though? It seems like they have. EMP, but look at this elsewhere. Akramaks are just taking the barracks here. Kiko with the BKB, pushing them away. Seems to be a lane of melee barracks. Kalank once again with the Echo Slam. Visage didn't have his BKB. He's gonna pop the cheese, run away. Make Believe surviving for now. Dream in no man's land. Tornado EMP. Meteor will end up going down as the ages though. They're looking to turn it around. Dream with the Boundless Strike with the Wukong's command. Hopes to get this kill on Appa, but Appa quick BKB. Forced off gets the hell out of there. They've got VP though with the Eidos. Can they focus him? Soul Assumption isn't enough. Dream gets the kill. And Yorkshire is losing too many costly kills in quick succession.
No buybacks on the Earthshaker or the Rubik. That's the second lane of barracks about to go down. Actually, make that all three lanes of barracks. It's now going to be mega creeps for the Dire. They will end up losing the Monkey King and the Spirit Drake, but they have buybacks. Now in the middle lane, they're coming in to finish what they started. Dream with the BKB going to work on the tier 4 towers. Blue Frog's going to help this case as well. Behind the Boundless Strike connects on Appa, disrupting his combination on the Invoker, but the Echo Slam comes in and unloads. It's the death of the Monkey King as well as the Spirit Drake, but the rest of Yakshas are being herded back into their fountain while the Ancient is about to fall. Kiko's coming to finish the job. They're trying to slow him down, but the GG is there. Akramaks was able to win.
The second team game of the day has also been won by the Akramaks, who now sit at 10 points. What a comeback, Kappa. You guys are now second on the leaderboard and this game went on for 61 long minutes.
Main itna hi chahta tha ki perform kare team, bhale haare ya jeete lekin acha takkar deke khele.
What a great decision to bring Kiko back because he really outperformed everybody else today, right?
Yeah.
What a victory for you guys. Akrid, going forward, this is going to be incredibly important because every point is going to count. And it's going to give you a good cushion for the high voltage points in the coming days, right? Great, today the Akramaks have earned 10 points and you guys have earned 6. Good job, guys. Congratulations and all the best.
It was a loss to start their U Cypher campaign. Then they bounced back to winning ways. But sadly, another loss for the Yakshas. It's tough to swallow this one, Jonty, because versus the Akramaks, you started in perfect fashion. You won Tekken, you were brilliant again, 3 out of 3 for Jonty. Lost in CS and Dota, but you won cricket as well. And so you got the two small wins, you could say. That was 6 points in the bag. Lost the 10 points.
So basically, our plan for the whole tournament was
to have a great start. Yeah. And that responsibility was on me because I played Tekken, that's the first match.
Yeah.
And basically, this is not my forte, but I still swallowed that up.
Yeah.
And the only issue was internal, maybe coordination or maybe the draft or something like that.
I mean, it's incredible. You're not a Tekken guy. You're a FIFA guy. You know, you've come into playing Tekken 2 months ago. How different has it been?
For me, I've been playing since quite a long time. It's been a decade that I'm playing.
Yeah.
So obviously, I have that tournament pressure and experience both. So I know how to handle things. So I believe if you do anything with dedication, you can slay anyone at any given day.
3 out of 3 for this man in Tekken, but they need to come back into winning ways. Momentum needs to come back for the Yakshas. Can they do it? Well, time will tell. For now though, a loss for the Yakshas. They need to bounce back pretty quickly.
And with that, we come to the end of day 7 on U Cypher Naya Sport Night Superstars. After gameplay, ke baad, leaderboard mein kaafi zyada changes aaye hain. Take a look.
If you want to catch the entire gameplay, log on to usports.in and do follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and YouTube. I'll see you here again tomorrow where the Yodhas will go up against the Crusaders. You are watching U Cypher, Naya Sport, Naya Superstars, a U Sports initiative. My name is Aisha.
And I'm Varun.
Do U Cypher.